dramatically, and there's major efforts going on to reduce hospital costs. I think that that's a big issue. And even though, you know, acupuncture is far less expensive than some of our in-hospital procedures dramatically, it's also more expensive than most medications. So I think that a big challenge is going to be one, who's going to pay for it, and then also looking at does it help decrease hospital stays? Does it help, you know, what are the parameters that it helps improve within the hospital setting? And there is some early research looking at improved white cell counts and neutropenic patients. There's some stuff like that, but I think it's going to be this, at least one of the real thorns that's going to need to be addressed, and there's going to need to be some solution. As you know, right now Medicare does not pay for acupuncture, and I think that it will probably be a while before they will, just because it's more money out of their pocket. A lot of other insurance companies are paying for acupuncture, but in the outpatient setting. So, you know, I think one issue is who's going to pay in the inpatient setting. And that's just an issue too, in and of itself, that in our current climate, you know, money who's paying is always at the forefront with any hospital administrator or whatever. And that doesn't address whether acupuncture is beneficial or not. That's just who's going to pay for it. So then getting into the other issues about research, if we can show that it is beneficial and it is cost effective and it does decrease inpatient hospital costs, then I think you have a no-brainer. That's going to take a little bit of work to do. There is some interesting things going on throughout the country, but I think most of it is predominantly outpatient type work at this point. The other things within, you know, challenges for getting acupuncture into the hospital, especially if we're talking about non-physician acupuncture, then the only reason I separate that category is because most physicians have spent most of their career, at least partially, within a hospital setting. And the challenge that I see, and, you know, and I'm in the process of setting up an inpatient acupuncture within the hospital, is that the rules are very different. You know, there's things that one can do within their private practice that they can't do within a hospital setting. You have infection control, you know, breathing down your mouth. You have, not breathing down your mouth, they have an incredibly important function to make sure that what people are doing, no matter who they are, from the physicians, the nurses, the technicians, the orderlies, the blood drawers, period, that they're doing what's necessary to limit the spread of